This is Spoken Gospel. We're dedicated to seeing Jesus in all of Scripture. In each episode, we see what's happening in a biblical text and how it sheds light on Jesus and his gospel. Let's jump in. God is punishing the people of Judah for their idolatry and evil with a severe drought. The ground is cracking, crops are withering, and even the hardiest wild animals are starving. The whole nation is mourning the death and devastation that God's judgment has brought. So, in a series of prayers, Jeremiah prays to God on Judah's behalf and asks him to lessen their suffering. Jeremiah admits Judah has rebelled and asks God to relieve their suffering, not because they deserve it, but because God's reputation is on the line. In the past, God described himself as the hope of Israel and his people's savior. So Jeremiah asks God to be true to his ancient names once again and rescue the people he loves and send rain. But God responds and tells Jeremiah the famine is fair. Judah's explicit evil and idolatry cannot be swept under the rug. Judah must pay for its crimes, and his verdict is final. God promises that if the famine doesn't destroy Judah, he will send an army for the survivors. And Jeremiah must stop praying for Judah's rescue and join him in announcing Judah's destruction. But despite God's command, Jeremiah writes another prayer on his people's behalf. Again, he acknowledges Judah's deep guilt and begs God to treat them not as their actions demand, but for his reputation's sake. But once again, God says Jeremiah's prayers won't stop his judgment against his defiant and guilty people. Jeremiah finally obeys and joins God in announcing the fall of Judah's obstinately evil nation. But delivering these prophecies of doom invites immediate opposition from those in power. Overwhelmed by both the gloominess of his warnings and the severity of their attacks, Jeremiah wishes he had never been born. But God promises Jeremiah that he will protect and deliver him from his persecutors. Jeremiah shoots back that he has already dutifully spoken every word God's given him, and that's only brought him pain. Jeremiah asks how God can be so calloused to his faithful suffering and why, like a mirage, he promises waters of relief but delivers only sand. Gently, though, God rebukes Jeremiah. He tells him to turn away from speaking such harsh words against him so that he might, in turn, give Jeremiah new words of encouragement and consolation. Jeremiah was born to be God's messenger, and only by joining God in announcing judgment will Jeremiah know God is faithful to his name, vindicate his reputation, and protect Jeremiah from his persecutors. Jeremiah is hesitant to join God in his denouncements against Judah. But joining God in his judgment against Judah is the only way Jeremiah will experience God as the hope of Israel and as his personal savior. Ironically, accepting and proclaiming the announcement of God's judgment is the only way to be saved. God's ultimate prophet, Jesus, asked God the same questions as Jeremiah. Like Jeremiah, Jesus announced the fall of Jerusalem and faced violent opposition from the religious leadership of Judah. When faced with the reality of his quickly approaching death, Jesus prays, and he asks God if there's any other way for God's people to be saved other than his destruction. And just as God said to Jeremiah, God tells Jesus, no. The only way Jesus and his people will experience God as the hope of Israel and as their savior is by accepting the deadly judgment of a Roman cross. Jesus carries God's message of judgment and dies. But just as God promised Jeremiah, God protects Jesus. 3 days later, God vindicates his reputation as the hope and savior of his people and raised Jesus from his tomb. Jesus was saved from death by accepting God's judgment. And the same holds true for us as well. The only way we are saved from God's judgment against our own obstinate evil is if we accept and proclaim that God has judged evil on the cross of Jesus. Jesus does not simply die as our example, but in our place. And when we accept and proclaim his good news of judgment, we will be saved from our persecutors, raised from the dead, and experience God as our hope and savior. So I pray the Holy Spirit will open your eyes to see the God who judges his people. And may you see Jesus as the one who accepts God's judgment so that we can experience his protection and eternal life.